Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and my friend Alex Powers, for you guys that join our live stream, you may know him as Hey Alex. He's put together a 30-day query folding challenge, and people out on the interwebs are like, hey, Guy in the Cube, you should take the challenge. So guess what? I've decided to take the challenge. Stay tuned. Do find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right. Alex is a huge fan of M, and he's always saying, guys, you should do more Power Query videos on your YouTube. And I'm like, kind of like the accent data modeling. But I decided to take the 30-day query folding challenge, and I found out there's lots of things you can learn when you're taking this challenge. I'm probably not going to record every single challenge. Along the way, I may find one that's really interesting and I want to come back and do a video on. But if you're interested in optimizing query folding and really understanding how it works, there's the value. You should go check this out. Go through the challenge because you're going to learn tons of things. In the very first challenge, I learned a good bit. All right. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing you need to do is head over to Alex's Git repo. It's not about a sale. And then you'll see a couple of things here. Let's go ahead and choose Power Query M. And in the Power Query M, you'll see a folder for hashtag 30-day query. Go ahead and click it. And then you'll see lots of queries. Don't click these. Just click this one, and it's going to open up PowerPoint in another window for you. And so here's the first challenge. Use database at VentureWorks DW 2017. Use the DIM employee. Here's the instructions. He wants me to select a few columns, employee key, gender, and birthday, and then merge full name, which is a concatenation of first name, middle name, and last name, with a space separator only for employees where birth date is 1974. Now, I'll admit, when I first attempted this challenge, I did the concatenation for every employee, and I missed that last part, but that's the gotcha. That's the trick. You have to figure out how to make that work. Let me show you the steps I took to solve this challenge. I'm a GUI guy. I'm a graphical user interface guy when it comes to Power Query. I attempted to solve this all with a graphical user interface. Let me show you. Over in Power BI Desktop, I already have them employee loaded. And so the first thing I did was I did the concatenation. So I'm going to find those columns. And if they're not in order, you can drag them in order. But if you click first name, hold down shift and click middle name, it'll select them all. Right click and choose add columns from examples. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that. Guy R. Gilbert. Boom. And I'm going to rename it to full name. Click OK. So now I have that column. That's the first step. Then he only wants me to choose a few columns. So I'm going to go to choose columns, unselect them all. And he wants employee key, birthday, gender, and that full name column. Now, the catch is I'm doing the concatenation for every employee. He only wants the concatenation to occur for employees born in 1974. How do you do that without going into the advanced editor? Let me show you what I did. Here on birthday, I clicked the drop down, I went to date filters, and I chose year, and I chose this year. No data, because no one was born this year in this table. So I was kind of stuck. I was like, what do I do? Well, I think that was Alex's intention, was you're gonna have to go into the advanced editor. So now I have to head to the advanced editor. Let me show you how I got to the solution by writing very little code. I'm gonna right click on DIM employee, go to advanced editor, and you can see everything here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna comment this out, go over here, get rid of this comma, and I'm gonna return just this. And now I need to figure out a way on my merge to do like some logic and say, if 1974, then this, otherwise null. So what I'm gonna do inside of this, let's say if year equals 1974, I know it's not right, then this else right here, null. Then it got me to thinking, here's the filter. So I just need this right here and replace it with my 174, which should be 1974. So I'm gonna do that and say equals 1974, but I'm gonna make a slight change because there's a function date.year and it'll return the year from that birth date. So basically I'm saying, insert this merge column called full name, iterate over each row, get rid of that. If the year of the birthday equals 1974, then do the concatenation, otherwise return a null. All right, click done. Let's see if that works. Boom! I will admit, the first time, right, when I solved this, it took much longer to get this figured out. But look, it looks like it works. So then I want to check my work. Before I check the work, I need to make sure this is folding. So over here in my applied steps, I'm gonna right click here. You can see there's my native query, but the challenge is this folding. Yep, boom, it's folding. That's a big query, but it's doing a case. It's saying, when it's this, do all these things. And it looks like it's doing a check. So if first name is not null, do it. Otherwise, put nothing there. And it does it for all of them. It's very cool. So it is folding back. So now I wanna check my work. I'm gonna head back to the repo and go to day one. I should have said spoiler alert. If you're gonna decide to go through this challenge, maybe you shouldn't watch all of it. But anyway, so check this out. Here's Alex's code. So I'm gonna copy this and then I'm gonna head back and I'm gonna do a new blank query and I'm gonna go into the advanced editor and just delete all this stuff, paste this in. I need to change some stuff. And we'll click done. Looks like my little solution worked. Let's click here, get rid of the nulls. Let's see how many rows he's got. 16, interesting. So let's go back to mine, see if I got 16. Same thing, let's clear that out. When I head over here and let's take a peek at Alex's query that's being created. It looks like his is a little more efficient. Let's go take a peek at what he's doing in his query. So he's not doing a text.combine. He's actually explicitly combining them using an ampersand and he's only doing a check on middle name. That's interesting. Mine's a little different. If you take a peek at mine, I'm doing text.combine. If you look at text.combine, first name, then a space, middle name, then a space. But where my fold is different is you'll see that the text.combine automatically adds a null check in for each column. I can't tell you which one is more efficient. I need to take those queries, run them on my database and see what the execution plan looks like, what the timings look like. But going through this challenge, you're gonna find out so many tips and tricks on how you can make that query optimal, you know, a little more optimal by doing certain things. Maybe you do a text.combine, maybe you need to do some explicit concatenation. Completely up to you. All right, what do you guys think? You got any questions? You got any comments? Have you tried this challenge? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.